Okay, so I think I've set the the tone for this today. There's a person out there purporting to be the finder. He put his story out on medium.com. The Fenn estate probably foolishly, in my humble opinion and in the opinion of others, put that link on the old Santa Fe Trading Company webpage where they had their announcement about the end of the chase, thereby, in my opinion, endorsing it or at least acknowledging the existence of the finder who put the story out on medium.com. Of course, we know that Forrest Fenn himself says there is a finder. Barbara Anderson wants to find out who the finder is. That's the whole point of her lawsuit. She wants to know who this person is that she is convinced stole her solve, hacked her. Now, before we go there, I am going to say this about that link that was put on the old Santa Fe Trading Company webpage. Keeping in mind, someone said that they had learned some information because they knew the finder was going to put out this story. They implied they know the finder. They kind of implicated the finder and that their location somehow was more believable because they must know who the finder was, you know? You're kind of taking it on faith. I'm not good at doing that. I always think people. Not always, but I'm very suspicious about people. If someone puts out a nude photo of themselves in older middle age, of themselves naked, and they look really good in the photo, and they say, "Hey, take a look at me." Now, this is a very scary thing I want you to do. I want you to imagine I right now am sending you a nude photo, okay? And I just look superior. I mean, I look like Adonis, my body. Wonderful body. But this is what I'm doing in the photo. Something weird about this photo? It's a photo of me, right? It's a photo of me in my birthday suit. You get it? You see anything weird about it? Where's my face? Bing, bing, bing. Any bells go off for anyone? Apparently not, because a lot of people, "Oh, you look fantastic, Eric. My God, you look like you're 25 years old. How do you even know it's me? I turn my face away from the camera." That's what I'm saying. There are a lot of gullible people in my search. Really? Okay. Saying that because there are just some people in the search community that really get on my last nerve. They seem to be almost flaunting. I don't know what they're flaunting. Flaunting their body, even though they don't want you to see their face. All right. This is what the finder comes back to write after he sees this video, apparently, and he has this guy who is found this location because of he knows the finder. He knows the finder. Why do we know that? Because he knew the finder was going to write his story before he wrote it. Was there any more proof than that? The guy said he knew the finder was going to write the story? Somebody just said something and so you believe it? Words, just words? All right, well, this is what the finder came back to say on Hint of Riches forum. All right? And it's still there if you want to go read it. Attention forum. This is posted by the finder. This is posted on date October 2020. 10th. It was posted on the 10th. Attention forum. Hello, everyone. I have decided to post a thread here because this is where the information stems from. He's talking about this story that the location of where the chest was is a known thing now because somebody who knew what the location was, and this somebody knew the finder was going to put the story out on medium.com, ergo that person has some inside information with the finder, right? Got me? Okay, so this is the finder now saying, calling himself the finder. I tell you folks, I'm always checking myself because everything is BS until it's proven, as far as I'm concerned. By the way, did I tell you, I trained both Tober and Bell to smell out bullshit. And we watched that video together, that video where they were talking about the bronze sniffing dog and all that. Both my cats sat down when they were watching that. And they looked at me. And I looked at them and I said, yes, I get it. You think this is bullshit. Okay, I get it. They're bullshit sniffing cats. They're good too. Attention forum. Hello, everyone. This is from the finder. I have decided to post a thread here because this is where the information stems from. I am in no way affiliated with sending anybody photos or GPS coordinates and have never given a private party inside information. I know people are going to read that and just dismiss it and say, well, that's, you know, this is just someone else playing head games. It never occurred to you the first guy is the guy playing the head game. And maybe this guy is for real. And he's saying, no, I did not give anybody information about the location, the GPS location. The area is sacred to forests. Therefore, the solution will never be revealed. But I do feel obligated to try and bring peace throughout the Chase community, so I will say a few things. There are GPS coordinates attached to the clues. Page 65 of The Thrill of the Chase will get you to Brown. The thought of toe-to-toe as in a tight race was correct. There was a father-son team Forrest told me about that was right on my tail, and I was very fortunate to find it when I did. I was never given names. Their names are the Hurst, father and sons. They're the ones that had the solve, they thought. And when they told Forrest what his opinion was of them going and finding the treasure at the end of the winter, Forrest's response was, well, there's still snow on the ground and the ice is still, or the mud is still slippery. So wait until there's no snow and the mud is dried and then go out. He talked them into stopping their search. He stopped them from going out when they wanted to at the end of the winter. They took his advice. And then in June, they claimed June 4th or 5th. Ding, ding, ding. They email Fenn or text him or whatever they did. And they said, do you think it's a good idea to go out now? Keep it in mind, in parts of these states, like I know Montana, I think because of COVID, opened June 1st. I believe Wyoming was open most of May. Anyway, Forrest told them, then, yeah, go ahead and start looking. And then he announces the next day or the day after that, it's been found. So they were just blindsided, and they're very upset about it. The Hurst, the father and son, the Hurst. They were in, I believe their solve was in the Kerwin area. The Kerwin area, something to do with a place called Brown Mountain, is that correct? I don't know. I'm speaking off the top of my head about that. That's the father-son team that Fenn was talking about. He doesn't even know their name, which surprises me. I've noticed that this finder sometimes seems almost oblivious to the search community, almost like, and maybe, you know, that's why he found it. He just followed his own, you know, he followed his own solve and he was not distracted by other people's theories, etc. This will be the one and only time, he puts that in quotes, one and only, quote. I don't know what that means. This will be the, quote, one and only, unquote, time I will post on this site. I hope this brings closure to some of you here and on other websites affiliated with Forrest Fenn. Good luck, and may you find your treasure in life. And then he shows this very strange photo of Forrest Fenn. Some people have said they think it's Photoshop. I think it's very odd looking. It's an odd look on Forrest's face. It just seems like an odd angle and everything else, but of course, maybe that's why it was never included in the original photos. It's just not a, another way of putting it would, another way of putting it would be it's just not a good photo of Forrest Fenn. I thought the orange on the arm was like he had an orange arm and a white hand and an orange face and a white neck. But the entire body, I mean, I went back and looked at the other photos, and I didn't see any photo that you could have manipulated to look like this one. So I really don't know. I'm not that good at digital. I like to play around with digital art, but I'm as far as analyzing things, I'm not that good at getting in there. People have software tools to do that, so they can tell whether how real that photo was. This all leads up to Barbara Anderson. This all leads up to Barbara Anderson. Barbara Anderson wants to find out who the finder is because she is convinced the finder hacked her computer to get to the Saul. That's why it's so important what happens when people do things like say they agree that a story by the finder is real because. When the Fenn family does that, I know I'm kind of belaboring this, but when they do that, they're opening up the possibility that someone will find out who the person was that created the story for Medium.com. Now, I personally don't believe Barbara Anderson or the court. I mean, I guess, again, my opinion, I'm not a lawyer, I don't know. If Barb, you're out there, let me know if this makes sense. Are you hoping the court will subpoena that person? I mean, is that what we're talking about? Subpoena the person who put the Medium.com story out there because now the Fenn estate agreed that the person who put the story out there on Medium.com is the finder? Kind of like they have seconded the motion that the finder is real and he wrote that because, as we know, people have said you have set up an account to be on Medium.com. I suppose you can give fake identification, etc. But from what I talked to, I think it was I was talking to, and he was saying it was they were the people that allowed him to set up an account on there were kind of seemed conscientious about it, maybe even a little gun shy about what he had to go through. So my point is, I guess what I'm trying to say is perhaps they did. You know, if they make if you really have to put your real identification of some kind to get an account on Medium.com, and then the Forrest Fenn family essentially says, you know, hey, thanks for that link. I mean, this is the real story. They're, you know, could that give Barbara Anderson the ability to have them subpoenaed? See, I don't know. This is when I'm talking just, I don't know. I'm not a lawyer. But it's very important because Barbara Anderson has a court case going on. Thank you, Scott, for sending me the link to this. This document is from the 6th of this month. Barbara Anderson, as her own attorney, hereby files this pleading responsive to the court's order of September 25th, requiring that Anderson tender a substantive response to a docket filed by former counsel for Forrest Fenn relative to claims brought under 18 USC blah blah. A docket is a it's a bit of information. It's a docket is part of a paragraph of a case could be a docket, meaning that in that paragraph, for instance, something is said or alleged, and you say, referring to docket 23, I'm responding to what was said at this point. Okay, do you understand? I had to look this stuff up. So anyway, Barbara Anderson wants to pursue the case and keep going on. Summers, the attorney, now gone. Fenn died. So this guy apparently is no longer handling the case. The background of this is that Anderson wants to have the case go forward, and she's kind of saying, I want someone to represent the Fenn estate so we can continue this. And I'm not going to get into that very much. What I'm going to get into, we'll keep your eye on the news. We'll see what happens as far as this case being sustained and whether Barbara Anderson can continue. But this is, luckily for people like me, laymen, they have a subtext. Kind of sums up what you're really talking about, and this is the good stuff. And this is what is so important, and some people think this is why the link on the old Santa Fe Trading Company, why the whole link to the Finder has been removed, to the Finder's story on Medium.com. In fact, all that stuff's been removed. The announcement by the Fenn estate about the end of the chase was removed. People said Shiloh put that on there. I don't know. That's just my opinion. Everything I'm saying today is just my opinion, cobbled together from people talking to me in the background, things I'm reading. I'm just another searcher out there that wants to know what's happening at the end of this chase, wants to know what's going to happen, wants to know what the real location was, how the clues fit, but also, was the chest retrieved? Is the chest in now possession of the Fenn estate, or is it really in possession of a finder? The really cool thing is that Barbara Anderson's going to address that. This is what she is trying to find out. Folks, I'm telling you, people have made fun of Barbara Anderson. Not cool. I read her text messages. I was kind of flipped the way I read them. I was kind of exaggerating things, but I tried to tell Barbara Anderson when she talked to me on that, back when I did those, when she commented. I made it clear that I'm not trying to make fun of her. I was trying to be entertaining. Maybe she didn't appreciate it. But folks, I'm telling you, Barbara Ann is our Barbara. Barbara Ann. Barbara Anderson is literally, possibly, our last hope to get anything out of the Fenn estate as to the reality of what we've been told about the end of the chase. A lot of people invested their time, their effort, their money in the chase. I know people are going to tell me, Eric, you're not entitled to anything. I don't care. If all I had in my life were things I was, quote, entitled to, I'd probably have very few things. Okay? You just don't go seek answers to things you feel you have an answer entitled to you. You think you're entitled to know things. No, there are plenty of things I'm sure people don't want to tell you, but you go out and you find out anyway. I really would love to know the truth about the end of this chase. Barbara Anderson right now is it, folks. Once her case goes under, you no longer have Forrest Fenn to talk to on the phone. You no longer have Forrest Fenn to communicate with emails. You no longer have any of that stuff going on. You are now talking to lawyers or the Fenn estate. That's it. And they're not going to talk to anybody. Who else is out there that could possibly have some answers? The inner circle? Maybe Doug Preston? Maybe Dale Neitzel? I don't know. But again, they can all keep their... I mean, under what pretense would you be able to get them to say anything anyway? As far as I know, from my little legal understanding, and I'm kind of getting little droops of how it works... Nothing. I mean, you just can't go around the country saying, oh, I think you might be involved. I want to hear what you have to say up on the stand. It's not the way it works. You got to have evidence. You got to have a reason to make people talk. So I don't know who at this point, now that Fenn is gone, Gabby Fenn, the guy who liked to talk a lot, I'm not even going to discuss what's coming up in a former video, but let's just say Fenn talked a lot. Okay? Enough of that another time. I have enough trouble keeping up with the things. Seems like every other day I wake up and I've got text messages and people are saying, did you see this? Did you see they removed the links? Did you see this? Here's Barbara Anderson's latest motion. It's like, man, this thing is rolling fast. You should get my point. Barbara Anderson right now, if someone wants to start a class action suit, and I've heard people talking about that, um, What would we be suing for if I was signed on to it? You know, a class action suit with a bunch of people? A class of people, I guess, is what they're saying, that want to sue over what? What have we lost? Any money I lost on that, say I spent 10,000 on 6 trips. It was my decision. I was looking for a treasure. I thought there'd be a payback. If it ever comes out that there was no treasure ever out there, I think then there could be possibly a class action lawsuit. But remember, even if you get a class action lawsuit going, I guess it's not hard to get some. I mean, it costs money to bring forth cases and stuff. But you know, a judge can also just look at the evidence if you don't have enough in his opinion and say, I'm not even going to bother with this. Other than a class action lawsuit, though, I don't think there's anything. So do not make fun. And I'm being very serious about this. Don't make fun of Barbara Anderson right now. She's it. She's our only hope, folks. All right. I got to get moving on. Oops. Time for part 3 coming up.